Today we are going to take a look at Nvidia. This is a tier one stock for me. They just reported earnings and I'm going to take a look at five things I really enjoyed about their earnings. But even though their earnings were great, the stock price barely moved. As we can see, the stock right now is down about 1%, even though earnings were phenomenal. So I am going to take a look at some of the risk of holding Nvidia right now. So let's get started. So first, let's take a quick look at their highlights. Record revenue of $5.6 billion. This is up 84% compared to the same time last year. Record gaming revenue of $2.76 billion, up 106% compared to the same time last year. Record data center revenue, $2.05 billion, up 79% from a year ago. All right, so the first thing I really enjoyed and what's the first thing I was watching was the overall data center growth, right? But before we go on to the data center, make sure to hit the subscribe button, the thumbs up. It really does help a lot with the channel. Overall, year over year did show some great numbers, 79%. But we saw quarter three of fiscal year of 2021 was 1.9 billion compared to quarter four of 2021 was also 1.9 billion. So there wasn't much growth the past two quarters. So I wanted to make sure that the growth had not slowed down. And here in quarter one of fiscal year of 2022, it shows that the growth is not done right now. And later on, we're going to take a look at the guidance where they mentioned this is going to keep moving. Nvidia did mention the sequential growth in data center came from both compute and networking products, primarily driven by the hyperscale customers. The second thing I was excited was their overall gaming revenue. But before we take a look at the gaming side, let's take a listen to today's sponsor. I want to thank The Motley Fool for sponsoring this video. Motley Fool is a company that provides investing insight and stock recommendations for investors of all skill sets and risk levels. You guys know I love finding new investing tools and resources to help me scout out new growth stocks. And right now I have a discount for one of my favorite services The Fool offers. Through The Motley Fool Stock Advisor Services, you get access to a ton of expert stock picks. Every month you'll get two new picks that are aimed at growing your wealth and to help you realize your financial goals. Stock Advisor's average stock picks have done amazing returns. If growing your money is something you'd like to do more of this year, you can visit fool.com/Jose Naharro or click on the link below for access to my special offer and decide if the stock advisor is right for you. Thanks again to The Motley Fool and now onto today's video.
Gaming revenue. It was up 106% year over year and up 11% quarter over quarter. The gaming revenue, which I think is pretty impressive, has grown sequentially every quarter since quarter one of fiscal year of 2021, which was same time last year. And the reason I find that very interesting is because the overall market, especially the gaming market, is very cyclical. Usually quarter three and quarter four of the years tend to be the highest because those are during holiday seasons, during vacation seasons, when people are home trying to buy graphics card, laptops, and other products like that. So it is pretty impressive to see the sequential growth for the past year. Nvidia did mention that the gaming side is definitely benefiting from the cryptocurrency mining demand right now, which is definitely true, but this is something we're also going to take a look at why it's different compared to 2017 and 2018 when similar stuff were happening. All right, so the third thing I really enjoyed was the automobile section. This auto section is one I really enjoy about Nvidia. Even though the revenue is super small, right? $5.6 billion total revenue, and this only makes up $154 million. It's more like noise for the company. They actually made more money from crypto cards than the automobile industry. But I do think this is a market that is gonna continue to evolve. In the first quarter of 2021, they announced so many new plans in the automotive section. They announced so many partnerships with a lot of big car deals. One thing, if you guys took a look at their GTC meeting, I definitely did a video on that of all the different customers, all the different products that they announced just this quarter. So as I am a huge believer of autonomous vehicle driving or smart cars, I can see this industry growing and I can see the partnerships increasing over time. I just think we are so early in the stages, but I could believe that in the upcoming years, this is going to be a good portion, not a big portion, but a good portion of Nvidia's revenue stream. The fourth thing I enjoyed was Nvidia's kind of movement to the CMP, this crypto mining processing unit. And it's pretty much a graphics card to kind of offset the demand of their gaming cards right now by crypto miners and to kind of push those crypto miners into these cards. The reason I enjoyed this market is one, it kind of gives us an understanding of how demanding the crypto market is really doing and how much is pushing the overall gaming side. Even though they're kind of in two different portions in the company's balance sheet, it can give us some form of insight. The second thing is many people might be like, Jose, there's a chip shortage right now. Why why is Nvidia focusing on these cards instead of just focusing on their actual gaming cards? They failed the requirements to make it as a gaming card. So I think this was such a great move because it adds a whole new form of revenue for Nvidia without really hurting their supply chain. Nvidia mentioned that this CMP crypto mining processor units generate about $155 million this first quarter, and now is reported under the OEM and other. So one thing a lot of investors are very worried about this overall crypto mining demand is similar to what happened in late 2017, early 2018. And during that time, there was a huge demand for Nvidia's graphics card, again, due to the mining demand, right? And once this bubble popped, that overall revenue was noticeable, right? Because there was a huge supply in online marketplace of graphics cards as miners were getting rid of them since there was no need to use them since the craze was over. So a lot of investors are worried that the same might happen right now, right? As we are seeing a bit of the decrease in certain crypto coins, that, hey, maybe we are going to see an influx of Nvidia cards again, which is going to hurt the overall demand of their cards from their main market. And during the earnings call, they kind of talked about this point right here. And the first thing is, during 2017 and 2018, the GTX model was already on its end, right? So we can see the 1070, the GTX was the 1060 to the 1080 Ti. It was already reaching its end of the line, right? We can see 2018 was right here. This was when the overall cryptocurrency mining was happening. So it was already happening at the end of this model's life. But if we take a look at the new RTX units, these are fairly brand new. The RTX 3090 came out in September 24th. The RTX 3080 came out in September 17th. The 3070 came out in October. This was during the time the crypto mining was still pretty hot right now. So the pent-up demand of gamers for these cards, or even content creators like myself, is still pretty high. So that is the main difference between the crypto mining back then and the crypto mining demand now, and how it might affect the company in the long run. All right, so the last thing I really enjoyed about this company's earnings is just the future, right? They gave us guidance for the second quarter, and they expect $6.3 billion of revenue. This is going to be another record revenue for Nvidia this upcoming quarter. That's going to represent a 62% year-over-year growth and an 11% quarter-over-quarter growth. Nvidia did mention on their earnings call during the Q&A section that they are expecting growth amongst all their markets sequentially, so that's pretty impressive. They also mentioned that the biggest driving forces are going to be the gaming and the data center revenue. Outside of that, they also mentioned that Mellanox 1 year in has exceeded their expectations and has transformed Nvidia into a data center scale computing company. They also mentioned that things are still in process of the ARM acquisition. At the moment, they still believe that an early target of 2022 is possible for the company. So at least there's no negativity in that news. I think the Nvidia team would want to really give us a heads up if anything negative was happening right now. Even though me personally, I'm more inclined that this deal or ARM acquisition might not happen, there's still some hope. So now I want to talk about my biggest risk about Nvidia. And I want to say right now, it's valuation, right? There's nothing I really disliked about their earnings, even though they were for phenomenal. Look at the overall price movements. The stock is actually down about 0.57%. And what does this tell me? This tells me that Nvidia right now is priced to perfection. If there's any slip up in the short term, it could create some negative noise for Nvidia. At the same time, as a long-term investor, I'm super bullish in this company. There might be some questions. Hey, Jose, what happens if I don't have Nvidia right now? How would I play it? First, because of that risk I just mentioned, I personally wouldn't open up with a big position. I would open up with a small position and dollar cost average over time until it became a position size that I was comfortable with. Sometimes you might buy high, sometimes you might buy low. Also, remember, you have to do your own due diligence and understand what you're buying. So take care, have a good day, and see you next time.